In this video, we're using the fx-991 EX scientific calculator to show you how to graph or solve for functions that have fractional values in them. And this is a scientific calculator, but the nice thing about it is that it has fraction templates where you can do, if you look over here to the left on the calculator keyboard, there's a fraction template where you can do mixed and fraction values, and also where you can convert. There's this standard to decimal where you can convert fractions into their decimal or mixed number form. So that makes solving equations that have fractions very easy because you don't have to convert them all the time. You can just use the templates to help you. So I'm going to show you two different ways you could use this calculator to solve. And I'm also going to show you the nice thing about the fx-991 EX is that it has a QR code. So that's right above here on the option button in yellow, where you can then see the graph of what you have shown. So we're going to first go to the obvious way, because if you give this to students, you're going to probably expect them to solve it by using their inverse operation. So isolating the variable x by doing the inverse of subtracting 5 or adding negative 5, which would be to add positive 5 to both sides. So their first step would be, you know, add that 5 to the side over here. And this is the calculation, negative 5 over 8 plus 5, that we want them to do. And a lot of times, you know, they're trying to do that with fractions. They're trying to find the lowest common multiple. But here's where that template on the calculator is going to help them be more efficient, right? They know obviously what to do. So now let's use the calculator to help us get to the next step. So I'm going to go into the calculate menu. So I'm there. I'm going to hit equal to get into it. And now I'm simply going to do this calculation using the fraction template. So I can hit the template and I'm going to enter my negative 5 and then use my scroll bar here to get down to the denominator position. And then scroll out of the fraction here and now add my 5. So all I've done is taken this calculation, used the template to help me, and then when I hit equals, I'm going to see the solution. Now the solution is in simplified fraction form, and so you'll notice that this is a improper fraction. I could, if I wanted to see the mixed number version of that form, the equivalent form, I would hit shift standard to decimal, and it would show me that this is really 4/3/8, but we really kind of want the students to work with it in this improper form first, and then maybe do their conversion at the very end. So we're going to leave it 35/8. The next step in this would then be to isolate the x by multiplying both sides by the inverse of 1/2, so 2 times 2/1 on both sides. So that's what this next step is showing, is we've isolated x, and on this side we have to do this calculation, so two fractions being multiplied. And again, here's where the fraction template comes into play. And I'm going to show you the different way you could use the template. Before, I hit the template first and we filled in the value, but you can also enter the number that's in the numerator position first, then hit the template, and it automatically creates that fraction, and now you just enter the back. That's the way I personally prefer to use it. So let's hit our times, and let's do 2 fraction template/1. And equals, and here's our final solution. And again, this is always the simplified version of the solution. Had students just been able to do this in their head, which they should have been, 35 times 2 is 70, 8 times 1 is 8, 70/8 is the unsimplified version. But we were given the simplified version, so you'll notice that that's this second solution here. So 70/8 is the same as 35/4, but now let's say the students are asked to convert it to its mixed number form. That's where this template comes into play. So shift standard to decimal is going to give me this 8/3/4 version of the answer. And then let's say they need it in decimal form, and they could hit that button again and get the decimal equivalent. So the nice thing here is these templates and these standard to decimal lets you see all equivalent forms of the same solution, which is a really nice way to look at it. So you can use the computation to actually do the calculations using fractions, and it's just going to save time. It's more efficient and it helps students see the connection. Another way, let's go into the menu again, is to use a table of values. Now this way takes a little bit longer, but it is another way to use this to calculate. So we're going to hit equals to go into our table, and what we're doing is, let's move this up so we don't see these anymore, is you enter each side of the equation as a separate function. So I'm going to enter this 1/2 x - 5 and then the -5s as two separate functions. So my first function, and here again, template is a nice thing that we have, so we don't have to change it to a decimal. We can just enter it as a fraction as we see it. So one fraction template over two. And my x variable, this calculator does have an x variable button that's right up here to the right under the on. And then subtract 5. So that's my first function. And my second function is just this other side of the equation. So negative 5 over 8. So we're going to hit our negative and our 5 template 8. That gets us there. And we hit equals. So now it's going to create a table of values. So it's looking for input x values that will give us this output. So when we're done, we're going to be looking for what input x has the same output for both functions. That would be my solution, right? So where do we want our range to start? Well, let's start at 1, but I feel like we maybe want to go at 10. And let's go by 1s just to check, because I want to show you how you're going to help students work with the table. So we're going to hit equals. And so we're looking for a place where the solutions of the two functions, so this is the right side and this is the left side of this equation, where they have the same solution. And so you can see they're not the same. And you'll see also that this one that had the one value is the same all the way through. So we're basically looking, where is f of x going to have this negative 0.625? Well, obviously, we're not even close. So let's keep going. And it looks like it's somewhere. So here's negative 1. And then the next, when we enter 8, it's a negative 1. When we enter x value of 9, it's 0.5. So our solution is somewhere between 8 and 9. We obviously didn't step by a small enough increment. So we can hit all clear, hit equals, and go through again and change our table. So this is kind of a fun way to help students understand how a table will give you values, but your precision depends on how you're stepping, how many values, those types of things. So we know our solution is somewhere between 8 and 9. So let's start at 8 this time, and let's end at 9. But instead of stepping by 1, let's step by something much smaller. Let's do like 0.25. And now when I hit equals, I still have a table of values, but it's between a positive 8 and a positive 9. But notice my solutions are much smaller, and I automatically see right away the one spot where both functions have the same output, which is where the solution is. And notice it's at 8.75. And if we remember from our work we did before, that is the decimal form of the solution. So we have found it using a table this time. So those are two different ways to help you get to a solution when you're working with fractional values. You can use the fraction templates and the standard to decimal. I did want to add in, when you're working with the 991EX emulator, another really nice feature is that it has the QR code that allows you to see a visualization. So we did this on the table, and we're still in the table, but if I hit Shift Option, which means QR, I get this QR code. And when I click that, so students who have a scanner can scan here and they'll see the same thing, but if you're working with the emulator, you just have to click here, and it brings up a visualization of that graph. So here's my two equations, functions that I put in the table, and notice it actually graphs those two lines. So here's the negative 5/8, and here is the 1/2 x minus 5, and it's showing you that this right here is where the solution is, 8.75. So it's also letting you visually see what that solution actually means. It's where there's the intersection of these two functions. So that's a really nice extra feature with the fx-991EX scientific calculator.